गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? अच्छा, इन द लास्ट क्लास वी वर स्टडिंग अबाउट चैप्टर 5 एसिड बेसिस एंड सॉल्ट. सो वी हैव स्टडीड लॉट अबाउट एसिड. व्हाट आर एसिड्स? एसिड आर द सब्सटेंस हैविंग सॉल्ट टेस्ट. एसिड आर द सब्सटेंस हैविंग सॉल्ट टेस्ट एंड द सब्सटेंस दैट कंटेन्स द एसिड्स प्रेजेंट इन दैम आर कॉल्ड एसिडिक सब्सटेंस. आर कॉल्ड एसिडिक substance. Then we saw about dilute and concentrated acid. So what acid which have large amount of water in them are called dilute, whereas acid which has very less amount of water in them are called concentrated acid. Then we saw about strong and weak acid. So acid which are highly corrosive are called strong acid, and which are very less corrosive, they are called weak acid. We also saw some uses of the acid like hydrochloric, sulfuric and nitric acid and acetic acid. We completed the exercise also. Now today we will learn about new topic, that is basic substance. What are the substance? Basic substance. The substance which contain bases are called basic substance. The substance which contain bases are called basic substance. They are usually bitter in taste and are slippery to touch. They are usually bitter in taste and are slippery to touch. Some of the common example of bases are sodium hydroxide and calcium hydroxide. Some of the bases we can see at our home are cornstarch, fresh egg white, baking soda. These are some of the common bases which are obtained from plants and animal. Here are some of the properties of the base which we are going to see today. Already we know acid are bitter in taste. What is the taste of acid? Acid are bitter in taste. Next, bases are, or solution of bases are, slippery to touch. For example, whenever you use soap, it is very slippery. So this shows that the bases are slippery to touch. This can be tested with any household base such as baking soda. When applied on hand and rubbed, it feels slippery to touch. Some bases such as ammonia have very strong odor, means their smell is very strong, and they can also cause irritation in our eyes, skin, nose. Next, bases can be highly reactive and therefore corrosive. Bases like acids are highly reactive, so in the same way bases are also highly reactive. Next, bases may or may not be soluble. Acid are soluble in water, but bases are having a condition, they can be dissolved in the water and they cannot be soluble. They are not soluble in water. Bases that can dissolve in water are called alkalis. Remember this point very essentially. Bases that can dissolve in water are called alkali. Example of alkali are sodium hydroxide, ammonium hydroxide and potassium hydroxide. So acid which can be dissolve in water are called alkalis. Now we will learn the types of the acids, bases. So students, there are generally two types of bases, strong bases and weak bases. So on what basis we classify the base? We classify the base on the condition that how corrosive they are. We classify them as how corrosive they are. The bases which are highly corrosive are called strong base. As we have learned in strong acid and weak acid, what are strong acids? Acid which are highly corrosive are called strong acid, and the acid which are not much reactive are called weak acid. In the same way, the bases which are highly reactive are called the strong base and are needed to be handled carefully. If in case they spoil it on their skin, it can cause destroy of your human tissue and may also cause severe burn. Some of the important strong bases are caustic soda or sodium hydroxide and caustic potash or potassium hydroxide. Okay, next, what are weak bases? So bases which are not much reactive, as I already told, which are not much reactive are called weak base. As they are much not reactive, they are not more corrosive also. Thus, they are not much harmful, and thus example of weak bases are copper hydroxide, zinc hydroxide and ammonium hydroxide. Okay, now we will see some of the uses of the base. So first use of the base is a sodium hydroxide. We are very very familiar with this sodium hydroxide. It is used in each of our home. It is used in the manufacture of soap and detergent. It is used in the manufacture of soap and detergent. It is also used to manufacture paper and tiles. In home, it is sometimes used for unblocking clogged drains. Second one is calcium hydroxide. So it is used for neutralizing the acidity in the soil. What is the use of calcium hydroxide? Calcium hydroxide is used for neutralizing the acidity in the soil. Second use of it, it is used for whitewashing as a constituent of plaster, cement and mortar. So whenever cement are manufactured, some amount of calcium hydroxide is mixed in that. Another major use of it is, it is a major component of body ex mixture. Now what is a body ex mixture? It is a mixture which is used in a pesticide. What is a body ex mixture? It is a mixture which is used in a pesticides for agriculture activities. What are pesticides? Pesticides are the chemical which are used to kill the pest. Just now the tit diesel and all came now. So they are used to kill such type of organism. Next, magnesium hydroxide. It is also known as milk of magnesia. It is also known as milk of magnesia or MgOH2. What is the use of magnesium hydroxide? It is used as an antacid or laxative. So some days you have seen, when our stomach gets little bit problem. What does the mama do? Mama asks to drink little amount of some medicine. So what are these medicine? These medicine are antacid. Thus, this means these are prepared from magnesium hydroxide. Next one is ammonium hydroxide, or also known as ammonia solution. It is used as a household cleaner. What is the use of ammonium hydroxide? It is used as a household cleaner, and it is also used for the production of fertilizers such as ammonium nitrate and ammonium phosphate. What is the use of fertilizer? Fertilizers are used to increase the productivity of the crops. Okay. So I think all have you understood about the base. Now we will talk about indicators. Now we will talk about indicators. What are the indicators? Indicators are the chemical substance that show a change in color when in contact with acid and base. So what are the indicators? Indicators are some of the chemical substance which changes its color when they react with either metal or with base. So what are the indicators? Indicators are some substance which change their color on reaction with bases or acids. What is the use of indicators? So indicators are used in laboratories to determine whether the given substance is an acid or it is a base. So what is the use of indicator? Indicators are used in laboratories to determine whether the given substance is a acid or a base. Now we will see some of the chemical indicator. So litmus solution, litmus come in two categories. It comes at this form as a solution, and also a paper comes of it. So litmus phenolphthalein and methyl orange are most widely used chemical to determine acidic or basic substance. So what are the main indicator found are litmus paper or litmus solution, phenolphthalein and methyl orange. These are the commonly used chemical indicators. So first we will see about a litmus. Litmus is most commonly in our school also we use litmus paper to determine the acidity or basicity of the substance. So what is a litmus? Litmus is most commonly used indicator. It is prepared from lichens. It can be either in the form of solution or it can be in the form of paper. Litmus can be either the solution or it can be a paper. So how can we determine that what is a acid or what is a base? We can determine in such a way that blue litmus turns red in presence of acid and red litmus turn blue in base. Blue litmus turns red in presence of acid. Now a question will come, sir, blue litmus turns red in presence of acid. What happens if we take red color paper? So there will be no change if we add a acid on red color paper, it will remain red. So blue litmus turns red in presence of acid and red litmus turns blue in presence of base. Another mostly commonly used indicator is a phenolphthalein. Phenolphthalein and methyl orange are the another two indicators. Phenolphthalein become colorless in the presence of acid. This is a point to remember. Phenolphthalein become colorless in presence of acid, while it turns pink in the presence of base. So what is the phenolphthalein? Phenolphthalein is an indicator. It becomes colorless when in presence of acid and pink in presence of base. Where is methyl orange? Methyl orange turns pink in presence of acid and turns yellow in presence of base. So this is three types of chemical indicators. Now we will see the natural indicators that are prepared from natural substance are called the natural indicators, such as turmeric, China rose flower, beetroot and juice of red cabbage are commonly used natural indicators. From where the natural indicators are formed? So they are formed from the parts of the plant like leaf, stem, roots, etc. So the juice of red cabbage turns into red deep color in acidic solution, purple in neutral solution and green or yellow in basic solution. Onion juice also show similar color changes.